Hello students, how are you all? I hope you are doing well at your home. So students, today in this video we are going to continue our same chapter, chapter number 3, A Gift of Chappals. Alright, so here we saw in the last video that how you know, Mirdu and Meena are exchanging their looks. They are talking about and they are like asking to the Ravi that why you are like how this thing is related to the kitten, what you are saying about the like the Pallava kings and the Egypts, the people worship, etc. So here the Ravi is replying to the Mirdu that who? I am telling you, this cat is descended from the Egyptian cat god. No, goddess, Bastet. Yeah, that's it. So please underline this word first. Bastet. So here, Ravi is replying to the Mirdu that you know what, that this cat is a descendant from other Egyptian god and like the goddess. So he's saying that this is the cat which comes from the like the, you know, the ancestor which comes from the goddess which people used to worship. The name is Bastet. So it's a, you know, a goddess usually shown as a woman with the head of a cat and it's wearing only one gold ring in the ear. So here the Ravi is explaining to the Mirdu. Now coming to our next para. So, well, one of the descendants of that cat goddess was a stowaway in one of the Pallava ships. And his descendant was the Mahabalipuram Rishi cat, whose descendant is Ravi. Flourished his twig at Mahendra, MP Pune here. Whoop! Ik is shrieked, is very pleased with himself. So here now again the Ravi is saying that, so Mirdu first replied that so means so what if you the people used to like worship to the goddess. Okay, so here the Ravi is saying that see, now this cat goddess is the one of the descendants, means she was one of the stowaway means here the meaning is given someone who hides himself or herself in a ship or an aircraft to travel unnoticed. Okay, so here the Ravi is saying that this kitten is hidden in the Pallava ships in the olden days, and this kitten is no one but it's the Mahabalipuram cat which I am talking about, and this is the same kitten. So here this cat is belongs from that Mahabalipuram Rishi cat. So he was like pointing out towards the MP Pune, and he's saying that this is the only you know, this is the only cat which I am talking about, and this is the cat from, this is the cat and this is the descendant from that Mahabalipuram's Rishi cat. Okay, so he was very pleased, means he was very happy with himself that the, and he shrieked, means he like a little bit screamed and he was happy and he gave a little sound. Okay, now coming to our next paragraph. Mahendra looked up and alarmed. He had just been sharpening his claws on the edge of the coconut shell. But worse than Ravi's awful whoop, it was a screech from the window. So now, here what happens, Mahendra means that kitten was, when she looked up, she alarmed, she got alerted that he had just been sharpening, means he, that kitten was just sharpening his claws, means his nails on the edge, or on the edge means on the corner of the, we can say the border of the coconut shell. Okay, now, Ravi's awful noise which he made, awful noise with the Ravi made, now other than this noise of the Ravi's like sound, there was a one more sound which was screech. So suddenly everybody is hearing this one sudden sound like of screech from the window. Okay, from that window where they were like outside the on the backyard, there was one window, and from there everybody heard the one sound, screech. Now, what a weird sound. If Mirdu was startled, MP Pune was frightened out of wits. Okay, so now here, what a weird sound. Weird sound means what a very strange sound it was. Means everybody heard that sound for the first time. Okay, and if Mirdu was startled, means Mirdu was shocked for of this sound, then how about MP Pune? MP Pune means how about that kitten, right? That kitten was also shocked and was frightened by that sound. Okay, his her hair standing on end. He bounced up and scurried towards a bamboo tray of red chilies that had been set out to dry. So what MP Pune means that kitten did is he just stand up from there, like he bounced and he just scurried, means he very fastly run towards a bamboo tray. So there was outside one bamboo tray, you know, a tray means a flat dish was there. In that red chilies were kept to dry. Okay, so he just bounced from there and he just went away on the other way. And the trying to hide beneath it, he tipped a few chilies over himself. Meow, he howled miserably. So here, you know, that kitten MP Pune is trying to hide beneath it, means under it. And he tipped a few chilies, means he just put the few chilies over himself to hide from the from that weird noise, and she was just frightened, right? So she just said meow, and he howled, means she cried very miserably, means very like, you know, unhappily. Alright, so here you can see that the small kitten, that MP Pune, is also very very, you know, frightened, we can say the afraid of that noise, and she is. The MP Pune is also trying to escape from that noise. So here comes our next para. The screeching went on and on. What's that noise? Said Mirdu. So now that noise was coming again and again. They were hearing that noise again and again. So Mirdu asked that, what is that noise? Okay. So here, that's Lali learning to play the violin, grunted Ravi. So now Ravi's grunted, means he's spoke very slowly, and he's saying that Lali is trying to learn to play the violin. Okay, she is there in the, like, you know, one place, and she is learning to play the violin. So that is the noise which we are hearing over here. So she'll never learn a thing. The music master just goes on playing like a train whizzing on and on, while Lali is all the time derailing, going completely off track. So here, the, you know, Ravi is trying to tell to the Mirdu that Lali will never be able to learn the thing, because music master always, you know, play a very good violin, and his violin is like, he's comparing the violin, music master violin, like it's a train which is going on the track and is whizzing a very good, means its sound is coming very good. Okay, but the how about Lali? Lali's playing is like, you know, derailing in the sense is the way she plays, and the way she plays the violin is not on the same way how the music master plays, like, so it's like going completely off track, means it's not going on like the train it's not going like the train which goes on the same track, means she plays the violin in a different way. She plays you know, the sound she makes by the violin is the different from the music master plays. All right, so this says that it's going completely off track. So here we have completed our first part of this chapter, and we'll see some question answers which are given over here. Okay, we'll just discuss, and you have to do it on your own. I'll just give you some hint about it. Okay, so our comprehension check, first question is given. What is the secret that Meena shares with Mirdu in the backyard? So we saw in the first part that when Mirdu is, you know, coming to his cousin's home, and it's Rukmani's home. So what is the secret that Meena is sharing with the Mirdu about the cat which they have found in the morning? That was the secret. Okay, so you have to make the answer, and you have to write over there. Then how does Ravi get milk for a kitten? So we also saw that how the Ravi is making the struggles to get the milk for the kitten. So he's going into the kitchen and he's trying to hide from the tapi, and he's getting the milk in the tumbler and giving it to the kitten, giving it to the cat for the in the coconut shell, right? So this is how the Ravi gets the milk from the kitchen for the kitten. Okay, so then third one, why does he say the kitten's ancestor are? Do you believe him? Sorry, who does he say? So, who says that there are the ancestors of the kittens also? And do you believe that there are the ancestors of the kitten also? So here, you know, Ravi is saying that this cat has come from the, you know, descendant of the Pallava king's time. And people used to like worship to the god goddess Bastet. Okay, so Ravi believes all this because he has been to the Mahabalipuram. He visited one place which is Mahabalipuram, right? And he visited like as a you know in the with his classmates for the picnic. So he saw over there, and so he's believing that this cat is a descendant from that Mahabalipuram cat. Okay, now fourth one. Ravi had a lot to say about MP Punai. This shows that. Okay, now Ravi says many things about MP Punai. So why does he say then? This shows what? So A, he is merely trying to impress Mirtu. B, his knowledge of history is sound. C, he has a rich imagination. Or D, he is an intelligent child. So correct answer is B, that his knowledge of history is very good. You can say is a sound. And now which of the statements do you agree and disagree to? So we agree to the statement number 2, alright. Now, fifth point, what was the noise that startled Mirdu and frightened Mahendran? So what was that noise that has startled, means that has frightened to the Mirdu also, and that has been afraid to the Mahendran also. So that noise was the creech noise, right? That means that noise came from the window, and when they are going near to the window, they are seeing that the Lali is learning how to play the violin. So that was the noise which came from the window. Alright, so these are our 5 questions. Okay, now coming to our second part. So here we will see that how the Mirdu and Meena and Ravi are going towards the window, and they are seeing from the window that how the Lali is trying to learn the violin. Alright, so here Mirdu crept up the window. Lali was sitting a little distance away, awkwardly holding her violin and bowstring, her elbows jutting out and her eyes glazed with concentration. Okay, now here the Mirdu crept out means she was looking out from, or you can say she was peeping out from the window. Okay, and she saw that Lali was sitting a long distance. There was a gap between, and Lali was sitting with the long distance. And she was awkwardly holding the violin. So there was a violin and bowstring, okay, in the Lali's hand. Now her elbows and her eyes were glazed with the concentration. So she was having a concentration on how to play the violin, okay. So in front of her, with most of his back to the window, was the bony figure of the music master. Now in the front of the Lali, there was one person. Who was that person? He was the music master who was teaching Lali to how to play the violin, right? Now he was a bony figure. Bony figure in the sense he was very, you know, thin in the size, right? Now he had mostly bald head with a fringe of oiled black hair falling around his ears and an old fashioned tuft. So now here in this para, they are describing about the you know, appearance of the that music master. So music master was having a bald head, means there was no hair on his head, okay, and he was having a little bit of a fringe, means he was having a little bit of hairs which was falling around his both the ears, okay, and they were oiled and black. So they were black in color, and he has put the oil in his hairs, and he was having an old fashioned tuft, means I'll show you in the photo over here. Here you can see this is the music master, okay. Now he is having, this is said to be, this is the, you know, having the in this ear he is having a hairs. This is said to be tuft. This is the old fashioned tuft. So he was here they are describing about the appearance of the music master. Now see what is next they are saying. Now, a gold chain gleamed around his leathery neck, and a diamond ring glittered on his hand as it glided up and down on the stem of the violin. A large foot stuck out from beneath beneath his gold bordered vestige, and he was beating time on the floor with the scrawny big toy. Alright, so here they are describing about the music master, right? So music master was wearing a gold chain. See, I'll show you. He was wearing one gold chain, and which was shining, which was gleaming, okay? And he was wearing one ring also. I'll show you. This is the ring which he's wearing, and he was wearing vesti. Vesti means you can say dhoti. Here you can see he has wear the dhoti, right? And he was holding one hand with the violin. He was having the other hand with the, you know, the, you can say the, it's the bowstring which he was with whom it was he was playing. Okay, now here they are comparing both the person, like how the Lali is sitting and is doing is playing the violin, and how the music master has sat and is playing the violin. Okay, now again coming back to a paragraph. So he played few notes. Lali stumbled behind him on her violin. So who is playing few notes here? The Lali stumbled. Before she stumbled, the music master played few notes, okay, with the violin. But when Lali stumbled, means she was not playing like the music master used to play. She was not getting the exact notes like the music master used to play the violin, which looked quite helpless and unhappy in her hands. So it seems like this is like, you know, helpless. She was not able to help herself and she was unhappy because there was a difference between how the music master used to play and how the Lali used to play. So here is a difference. Okay, the music master note seemed to float up and settle perfectly into the visible tracks of the melody. So here they are saying that the music master was playing the violin. His notes were so, you know, very perfectly set, you know, there was no any disturbance, and there was the tracks and the melody was going in a perfect manner. But it was like the wheels of a train fitting smoothly into the rails and whizzing along. So here they are comparing the music master's, you know, playing the violin. It's like the wheels which are going on the track and which are going on the rails also, and they are whizzing, they are making a sound. And along as the Ravi said Mirdu. So this all is said by whom? By the Ravi, that this is how the, you know, music master is playing the violin. But Mirdu stared at that huge beringed hand moving effortlessly up the violin stream, making lovely music. Okay, so here now Mirdu is only Mirdu's focus is only on that ring. Okay, so underline this word beringed. See, beringed, the meaning is given, means the music master is wearing a ring. So Mirdu's focus was on that ring. While the music master was playing the violin, her hand was moving up and down, right? And so in the same way, he was wearing that ring that was gleaming up and down. So Mirdu was just staring at that ring only. Now, what happens next? See, squeak. Swag, there was a Lali derailing again. So here the kind of the noise which Lali was making, like while making the while playing the violin. So it was like that she was not able to, you know, play the violin. She was not able to do that how the actually the violin works. Okay, so there was one sound came, squeak, right? And who did that? That Lali did that. Now suddenly in between that they were so from the window that Lali is playing to how to play the violin, and suddenly in between there comes a noise. Now what is that noise? You will see over here. Amma, came a wail from the gate. Amma. Oh, so here somebody is like, you know, like speaking very loudly and crying and saying Amma, oh Amma. So we'll see who's that. So here, Ravi sent that beggar away, cried his mother from the back Vardaha, where she was chatting with Tapi. So here, who is saying It's Ravi's mother is saying to the Ravi that please send that beggar away. So there comes one beggar like in between, and he's from the back veranda. Veranda means the backyard of the you can say the house, or you can say the gallery means the veranda. So his mother said that you just send that beggar away from our house. Where she was chatting, chatting means she was talking with the Tapi. Okay, now he has been coming here every day for the past week, and it's time he found another house to beg from. Pati explained to Tapi. So here, you know, they are talking with Pati and Tapi are talking they are talking together, and they are saying that this beggar is coming since one last week. Okay, he is coming since one last week, and now it's time that he has to find some another house for to beg from, or to take the, you know, the things from, to take the things like money or food, etc. Okay, so these things are explained by Pati to the Tapi. Now we will see what happens next. Now Mirdu and Meena followed Ravi out. The beggar was already in the garden, making himself quite at home. He had spread his upper cloth under the neem tree and was leaning against its trunk, apparently prepared to take a little snooze while he waited for the arms to appear. "Go away," said Ravi sternly. "My Pati says it's time to you to find another house to beg from." So now here what happens, when the Ravi's mother is calling to the Ravi and saying that we need to send this beggar out of our house. So Mirdu and Meena were also following to the Ravi. So now the beggar was already in the garden, okay, in the house garden. And he was making himself quiet at home. Means he was trying that to sit over there and to take the rest over there. So what he did, he spread his upper cloth under the neem tree. So he was sitting under the neem tree, and he just leans against his trunk. Means he was just taking the support of the trunk of the tree. He was taking the support, and he was just trying to take a snooze. Means he was just trying that he'll take a short sleep from here. Okay, from he will stay over here, he'll take the rest, he will take the short sleep. And he waited for the arms. Means he waited that somebody, ALMS, arms, underline that word. Arms means he was waiting for the house members will come and they'll give me some money or food to eat. Okay, so he waited for that, but nothing happened. And Ravi is saying that go away. So Ravi is saying to the beggar, please you just go away from here. Sternly means very in angerness and very strictly. Okay, so my Pati says that it's time to you to find another house to beg from. So my Pati told me means my mother, you can say grandmother told me to find the another house. Okay, if you want to beg something, or if you want beg from anybody, you don't come to our house, you find some another house, you search from another house. So this is about how the Ravi saw that the suddenly they found the beggar is used to come at their home and used to demand the things. Okay, so this is about our this para. Now coming to our next para, so here now what happens, let's see. The beggar opened his eyes very wide and gazed at each of the children one by one. "The ladies of this house," he said at last in a voice choked with feeling, "and are very kind souls. I have kept my body and soul together on their generosity for a whole week. I cannot believe that they would turn me away." He raised his voice. Okay, so now here what is happening, you know, beggar was taking a little sleep over that under the neem tree. Okay, now suddenly when he opened his eyes, so his eyes were wide. Okay, he was in shock sense, and he was gazing, means he was looking at the all the children one by one. So there was Ravi, Mirdu and the Meena standing over there. So he was looking all of them. Okay, now he said that the ladies of this house, means the in this house all the ladies are very, you know, kind souls. It's like they are very good souls, because in the last voice he said, means he was, it was the last time he was speaking, and he was saying to the children's, because he, the reason he'll say why he's saying in this way, they are very kind because they have kept my body and soul together on their generosity for a whole week. So to keep the body and soul together means they have managed to make me stay alive. So they have provided me the food and the, you know, the basic like eating things. So they have kept me the alive. So they have managed me to stay alive, because if they would have not given me the these things to eat, I would not have survived for the whole week. So this is the you can say the generosity, or you can say the kindness which they provided for the whole week. Okay, so here, I cannot believe that they would turn me away. So here the beggar is saying that I didn't knew that, I even can't believe that they will tell me to go away. Okay, so he raised his voice, so he speaked in a high voice. Okay, and he said, Amma, Amma, oh, said his wail might be, but it certainly wasn't feeble. It began in a deep, strong rumble somewhere in his withered belly and came booming out of his mouth with its few remaining teeth stained brown with a bitter chewing. So here he is, you know, trying to like say that Amma, Amma, but that was useless, because now it was a time, he also know that now this is a time to now leave this house, because now these people also don't want him, don't want the beggar to stay over here, right? And to again like beg from the this from again beg from all these people, right? So he also understood very well that this is the time to leave the house. Okay, now we will see the all the next paras, remaining paras in the next video. So as of now, we are doing up to here only. So you have to read the story, and again, if you want to know what happens next, you can read from the reader and you will get to know. Okay, so students, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.